The race for Washington's governor's office is now the most expensive in state history. The campaigns and supporters of challenger Dino Rossi and incumbent Chris Gregoire have raised a total of $38 million. KXLY4's Eric Loney spoke to both campaigns tonight. And Eric, they told you we can expect to see millions spent the last weeks of the race, right?
Yeah, they told us you can expect to see even more ads on television for the next 21 days. And now since the whole state does mail-in ballots, they told us every day is now an election day.
Our economy can't afford more of Gregoire.
The mud is flying over the airwaves.
The last thing we need is a George Bush Republican like Dino Rossi.
Most people told us tonight they don't like negative campaign ads.
I hate them. I hate them.
None of it's true, basically. They're just trying to, you know, take a piece out of the other guy.
Dino Rossi.
We can't trust him to be for us.
She gambled the economy would go up and up.
So we asked both campaigns why use negative ads, and we were told if they didn't work, they wouldn't. But they do work, and one reason why is people remember them.
It's just getting ridiculous. I mean, just how outlandish the ads are, and just a lot of scare tactics, and I'm getting to the point that regardless of what party they come from, I'm not really paying attention anymore.
Don't expect the mudslinging to stop. This race is now the most expensive in state history, and both campaigns have money left to spend until Election Day. New campaign filings say Dino Rossi now leads in the money race. He's raised a total of $22 million between his campaign and his independent supporters. Gregoire and her supporters have collected $16 million. $38 million total.
It's terrible. There's so many other ways to spend that money. It should be capped.
She's done to Washington State what they've done to America.
So whether you support Dino Rossi or Chris Gregoire,
even I was surprised by what Dino Rossi said about our economy.
All voters seem to agree on one thing.
Yeah, I'm just looking forward to the whole thing being over.
It's only three more weeks, so it'll be done.
Now, this race is considered the closest governor's race in the country, and most polls have the two candidates separated by only 2 to 4 points. Reporting live, Eric Loney, KXLY4 HD News.